Meteorologist Jamie Warner.
Well, it is after the middle of September, but it feels more like August as heat and humidity has sort of bullied its way back into the area. We're going to be dealing with this for the next several days. And with this heat and humidity, we actually have a few isolated showers also on radar. They've been kind of focused over toward Highway 63. Looking right now at what we have on the map, most of it south of the state line. You can see we have one isolated shower to the northeast of Salem. Looks like we've got a few isolated showers also in and around Melbourne in north central Arkansas. Otherwise, looks pretty quiet across the Ozarks. That has not been the case on the east coast. The good news is areas that have been so hard hit with rainfall, and there have been locations near Wilmington, North Carolina, which have seen 2 to 3 feet of rainfall since all this began late last week. Well, the remnants of Florence are finally moving out. There will be the threat for a few showers and thunderstorms through tonight, through tomorrow. But after that, it looks like a long dry stretch that'll take them through the weekend. And Florence looks like it'll finally move off the coast tomorrow afternoon. Meanwhile, back here in the Ozarks, we've got a building ridge of high pressure, which is leading to the heat out there. Also, the Gulf of Mexico is wide open, sending humidity north into the area. And it looks like that building ridge will be gliding across the area over the next several days. This is through Thursday evening of this week. And you can see by then that ridge will be centered over the southeastern U.S. So as it moves across the area, that's going to keep things pretty quiet. It's also going to keep things hot. We're talking highs in the upper 80s to low 90s each day through Thursday. And then once we get past Thursday, we're going to have this front approaching from the northwest and also some Pacific storminess, I think, interacting with that front. And that should generate a wetter pattern starting Friday that will continue through this upcoming weekend. I'll have more on that in a second. Here's our hour-by-hour forecast. And for tonight, starry skies. It'll be a quiet night on the warm side. Then for tomorrow, we'll start off with sunshine giving way to partly cloudy skies, I think, again tomorrow afternoon. And there could be a few isolated showers dotting the map as we work through mid to late afternoon, with that activity fading as we're approaching sunset. Temperatures tonight will range from the upper 60s to our east and south to closer to 70 degrees, I think, in areas near and north of I-44. Looks like about 69 here in Springfield, with a high tomorrow up around 90 degrees. Winds light out of the southwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. And you're thinking 90s here at this point in the fall season. At this point in September, are we getting close to record highs? Well, not too far off. You can see the record high for tomorrow in Springfield is 94 degrees. So we're not going to quite get there, but again, unusually hot for this time of the year. A 7 on our colorator, and that's because of the heat and humidity. Looking at this upcoming weekend, I mentioned how things were going to become more unsettled. Looks like we will have a front draped across the area by Saturday, with a storm rippling along that front across the area Saturday into Saturday night. And that looks to be a pretty good setup for rainfall. In fact, one of our models that we're looking at, which is a pretty good one, is actually hinting that there could be a lot of rain focused around Saturday. We could be looking at maybe a few inches of rainfall, and there could be even locally higher totals. It just depends on how this storm sets up, and we'll know more as we approach the weekend. Your 7-day forecast looking like this. Again, partly cloudy, hot and humid Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. It looks like Wednesday may be our hottest day, with highs of around 91 or 92. Heat index values are going to be back in the mid-90s those days. Lows around 70 degrees. Friday, I think, as the front approaches from the north, a chance for a few showers and thunderstorms. But the best chance for rain and thunder, I think, will come on Saturday, which, by the way, is when fall arrives. That storm clearing out of the area as we wrap up the weekend and head into early next week.
So on Saturday.
On Saturday. Okay. And you can see the big downshift in temperatures. Mm-hmm. We go from highs around 90 over the next few days to looks like temperatures in the 70s over the weekend. But that's mostly due to the clouds and the wet weather.
I can remember we've had 90s in October before. So, we'll have to watch it and see what happens. Yeah. How about our viewers club number?
Number tonight is 245-021. Our jackpot stands at $700.
All right, Jamie, thank you. And